What's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. So this is gonna be a very different video, not in the kitchen, but actually in my dining room. As you guys know from the title and thumbnail of this video, I'm gonna be doing a little mukbang get to know me video. I'm trying to experiment with my YouTube channel and kind of do some different videos outside of the kitchen. So if you guys have any suggestions, any challenges, any other types of videos other than cooking that you guys want to see from me, just drop down in the comment box, let me know. Primarily, I want to do this video because I have some new subscribers that I personally haven't met yet. So I'm gonna do this video so you guys can get to know me. If you guys are new to my channel, make sure you guys go hit subscribe. We're on our way to 500 subscribers. We're almost there, just a little bit more. So make sure you guys go subscribe. And if you guys are big fans of sushi, go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up because wow, look at this spread. I got the, I think it's called the Love Boat from Wakano. And I am starving. I haven't actually ate anything an entire day today. I'm lying, I had a peanut butter and jelly sandwich or a Smucker's this morning for breakfast, but that's about it. I had a coffee and a Smucker's, so I'm starving, but I've been saving my appetite for this video. So let's go ahead and get started. As I eat, as I go along, I'm gonna, you know, tell you guys a little bit about me so you guys can get to know me. So, I mean, as you guys know, my name is Damien. My real name is not Damien Boss, but that's just kind of like a nickname that I've had for a really long time, actually. I think since high school. I have no idea or remember where it even came from. I have my soy sauce right here. But I had it since high school, like 9th or 10th grade, and then it kind of just stuck with me. And I've used it for like all my social media handles. So good. Just melts in your mouth. I use it for all my social media handles. Yeah, that's how it came about. So, Damien Boss, that's what I'm gonna, you know, that's my YouTube channel. That's where you search me up, Damien Boss. I was born and raised in East Los Angeles, which is about maybe 4 to 5 miles from downtown LA. East of downtown LA, of course. I have one younger brother, my little brother Ivan. If you're watching this, what's up to you, Ivan? Shout out to you. One younger brother, no sisters. My parents kind of slept on that. My parents are from Mexico, from Jalisco, Mexico. My mom is from Guadalajara, and my dad is from a rancho about 2 hours from Guadalajara. So, if you guys know about the rancho life, I'm about the rancho life. Banda, tequila, you name it. That's my shit right there. Latino gang, as my friend Jay Bobbin says. He's not my friend, but. This is so good. Funny story, I was not a big fan of sushi before. I was not down. I was like raw, how do people eat raw fish, you know? It didn't sit well with me, but I actually went on a work trip with two of my coworkers. We went like out of state for an event for work, and they like wanted to go eat, and I was like, and they said sushi, and I was really new to the company, so I didn't want to be like that guy who was like not down to eat sushi when the rest of the group was down to eat sushi. So I was like, whatever, I'll get like chicken teriyaki and rice or something, right? And they're like, you have to try a California roll. Like that's like for beginners. That's where you're gonna start. So whatever, went and I had a California roll and it was so good. And especially cause they got it with cream cheese inside and avocado. I love avocados. If you personally know me, you know I love avocados. So I was like, okay, screw it, I'll try it. And then slowly and surely I was like trying new types of sushis. Like every year I was like digging into like just, you know, the raw stuff, the baked stuff, like going to albacore and tuna and shrimp. And I was just like trying new things. And look at me now, trying like raw ass salmon. It's my favorite thing. I actually prefer this fresh sushi than the actual baked one. It literally just like melts in your mouth. And if you don't like sushi, just like give it a try. I personally have not had like these rolls right here, the rolls wrapped in seaweed. So I'll give you guys my, what's the word? My reaction to biting those, but everything else I love. Yeah, grew up in East LA. I went to Wilson High School in El Sereno, home of the Mighty Mules. And then after high school, I moved away to Long Beach and I went to Cal State Long Beach for 5 years. I got my degree from Long Beach and then graduated from school and ended up just working, joining the workforce. I have a 9-to-5, I still have a 9-to-5. I'm not gonna tell you exactly what I do for work or where I work, just for privacy reasons, but I do work in the events industry. I plan and put on live events. So, yeah. I'm so hungry, you guys. This is just like hitting the spot. But yeah, I work in live events. Excuse me. Work in live events. I've been doing that for, I think, around 5 years now. And it's been awesome. I love it, it's fun. I love to travel. I've been to so many different places. Thankfully, I've been blessed to be able to have different opportunities to travel with work and without work. Anytime like that you guys could just save money for a vacation, for a trip, like it's so awesome being able to see the world. And there's just so many awesome places out there outside of our hometown and our home. So if you're definitely able to, you know, save $100 every week, every month, however long, however much you need to save to travel, I recommend you do it. Because you cannot go wrong with visiting and spending your money in other cities and other countries, you know? So yeah, definitely recommend you guys do that. I don't have any pets. I mean, we've had like a couple dogs here and there, like at home with my family, but not like a huge pet owner. I like dogs, don't get me wrong, but like, do I die to own one? Nah. So yeah, no pets. What else? What else do you guys want to know about me? That was good. I don't know if I'm really hungry, but the sushi is just super good. So my birthday is April 30th. I am a Taurus. Now, I don't really believe in like astrology. Is that what it's called? Astrology, right? Yeah, I don't believe in that stuff. So if you tell me like, oh, you have Taurus tendencies, or you're compatible with this person, compatible with that, I don't know any of that information, right? Talking about compatible, I'm in a relationship. I've been with my girlfriend Lucy for 2 years now. We just celebrated our 2-year anniversary. I did a really cool vlog, kind of vlogging the behind the scenes of our anniversary setup and kind of what we did here at home. Well, if you guys want to see that, it's up on my channel. But yeah, it's behind the scenes. We've been together for 2 years. We live together. We're happy as we could be. And huh, it's been great. Some of my favorite sports, I would say, is probably basketball and baseball. Not a football fan or football person. I think primarily it's because, like, growing up, like, football wasn't a big thing in my household. My dad doesn't like really watch it. We didn't play football. I played a lot of sports when I was younger. And yeah, I played basketball, I played baseball, but at the park where I grew up at, they didn't offer football as like a recreational sport. And so yeah, I didn't play football. So basketball, my team is the Lakers. I love the Dodgers. I love going to Dodger games. I go to more Dodger games than Laker games, you know, because of the price. It's much cheaper to go to Dodger games. But yeah, both are really fun. I would say my favorite fast food restaurant is McDonald's. I love like chicken nuggets and their french fries. Like I could literally eat a 40 piece by myself probably. Yeah, I love McDonald's. I love the beach and I love the water. Like anytime I travel anywhere, I like to go to places that are like right near the water or something that I could do that I could get inside the water. I'm kind of bummed that it's already, summer has officially started here in LA and we have not gone to the beach yet, you know, because of COVID. But yeah, hopefully we get to go soon because it's gonna get really hot here. But yeah, haven't gone to the beach yet, but I love the beach, love the water, love doing like those water activities, snorkeling. I don't know how to surf, but you know, I'm down to like do all that stuff. I love roller coasters. I'm a huge Six Flags fan. I'm down for all of that. Something that I would never probably do though, oh crap, is bungee jump or skydive. Probably won't ever do that. Too scary for me. Can we eat the tail? I don't know if you can. All right guys, so I'm gonna go ahead and try this roll. It's wrapped in sushi. I've never had it. I've had sushi. Sorry, it's wrapped in seaweed. I'm gonna dip it in my soy sauce here. Take a bite out of it. Let's see how it is. I've never had it. So you guys are getting my first reaction of whatever you call this. I think it's a hand roll. It's good. It's like a sushi burrito. I like it. I'm kind of bummed I can't have any spicy stuff. Normally like I would dip this in sriracha or spicy mayo, but unfortunately there is gallstones in my gallbladder and getting them removed soon, but in the meantime can't have anything spicy because I'll get a lot of pain and I don't want to be in pain. So no spicy stuff for me, but all good. Wow, that was good. That was really good. It's like so fresh, the sushi. It's good. I'm gonna say, I got this from Wakano, if you've been there. The Luck Boat. So good. So, you guys are gonna be wondering, why did I start YouTube? And I think I've always had YouTube in the back of my head. I just wasn't like brave enough to start it. Like I was always telling myself that it was a lot of work, which it is. And you know, of course, like you kind of feel embarrassed and you're like, what are people gonna say being in front of the camera? Like, you know, it's just like, it's tough, like putting yourself out there like that. And I definitely want to be mindful and not overshare some of my stuff in my life, but I do want to share stuff from my life, you know, because I feel like I have a pretty awesome life, blessed with a beautiful family, great group of friends, and I've gone to experience so many awesome things and places, and I want to share that. I want to provide like entertainment and entertain people and make people laugh and help people cook amazing meals. Like just want to do a bunch of stuff. I started my channel doing like cooking recipes, and I'm still gonna continue to do that, but I also wanna, like I said earlier, I wanna explore new things and kind of get into making some challenges and trying out just, I don't know, whatever viral things people are doing and just creating really fun content like outside of the kitchen. I love cooking, I love filming recipes with you guys. Don't get me wrong, I'm still gonna do that. I'm literally melting your mouth. But I'm trying to do more of that. I don't wanna, to be honest, I don't wanna do recipes forever. I wanna do like fun videos like this, like mukbangs or challenges with my friends and, you know, vlogs with my family and when I travel, like that's the videos that I eventually wanna make my channel all about. So if you guys have any suggestions, just leave them in the comments. I really appreciate it. But yeah, that's one of the primary reasons that I started YouTube. I was temporarily laid off from my job a couple months ago when the pandemic first started, and I did not want to be bored at my house just sitting on my couch watching TV the entire day. I'm the type to just be really productive and always be doing something. So I said, now is my time to pick up the camera and start filming and recording. So I started back in March 2020, which is now, I think we're on June, so it's been a total of 3 months of YouTube. And it's been cool. I mean, I think the biggest thing I've learned is to be consistent and really listen to you guys, the people watching my videos, and kind of what things you guys want me to do. And as long as I'm having fun doing it, I'm still gonna continue to do it. I love making content and just sharing with you guys, so gonna continue to do that. I think it's been really, really fun for me. Not gonna stop, and just, you know, just gonna kind of ride the wave, enjoy the journey, and see where it takes me. So I really appreciate you guys watching and just sticking with me, and just always dropping comments and love, all that good stuff. It's fun. Now, you guys will definitely see more of my personality. I think with these different types of videos, it's super hard to like show your personality in those cooking videos because you're not really talking outside of the recipe. You're like solely focused on talking about the recipe and the steps and, you know, giving people directions on how to make something. So it's super hard to like not be yourself, because I'm myself, but more or less show your personality, you know? So I think I could be super funny. I think I am one of the nicest guys you guys will ever meet. I feel like my intentions are always good. I'm such a people person, and I enjoy like having great relationships with people at work. Like you could ask Lucy, like I'll say like thank you to like, I'll talk to like anyone at the grocery store, at a restaurant, at the drive-thru, like I'll just like, I don't know, I enjoy just being friendly and nice to people. Like literally like makes you feel good, it makes them feel good. So I love those. There's memes that say like it costs $0 to be nice to people. Like literally, I don't understand how people are mean, or excuse my language, bitchy like to other people. Like it's just not cool, and it drains you, and it's not the type of negative energy that I want in my life. Or I don't want no one to treat my parents like that, my family, my sibling, like, you know. So yeah, growing up, I grew up going to the park a lot. Like I was never home. Like both me and my brother, we were always like at summer day camp. We were playing sports. We were in like after school clubs doing homework. Like we were never home, you know? But, which I love. Like we had an awesome childhood. And I think that made me like think who I am today. I like was able to be around really awesome people growing up and influenced by the right people. So motivated to work hard. I think my ultimate goal in life is to own a really beautiful house, a big beautiful house with like a backyard with a pool, a barbecue grill, somewhere in the suburbs, with a Tesla parked in the front. And I want the freedom of making my own schedule, right? Like, I don't wanna have to wake up, leave the house to go to work, come back. There's nothing wrong with a 9-to-5. I currently have a 9-to-5, but that's the type of freedom I want, is to like be able to work when I want, for how long I want, you know? So that's what I'm working for. By the way, this is like the Tazo, I think I'm saying it right, passion fruit tea. It's really good. It's diluted with water because it's a little too strong. but it's really bomb. But yeah, I want to, yeah, I just want to like have the freedom, you know, freedom of time, spend time with my family, like all that good stuff. A typical, I think, weekend for me, like if you would say like, what's a good weekend? I'm honestly, I think I've become like such a homebody and I just want to stay home. Like this whole pandemic and like stay at home order that happened here in LA and California, literally like living my best life here at home. Like I feel like before the pandemic, and I think just in general in 2019, I was traveling so much and busy. I've had two jobs and working on the weekends sometimes, and you know, it's tough. Like I feel like the pandemic finally gave me that break that I needed to just stay home, enjoy home. Like I'm not the person to sleep in, but it's just like like I didn't have to like be on a schedule, you know? Like I love on the weekends because I get to like wake up and not be on a schedule, because I think Monday through Friday I'm so like go by my calendar, like whether it's work meetings or errands or you know, whatever I need to do, I'm always like on the schedule. But yeah, I don't have to be on the schedule on the weekends when I have like zero plans to do anything or go anywhere. So yeah, I really enjoy a weekend at home where I get to maybe go in the pool for a swim or go to the beach and just relax. I've been really into barbecuing lately. Like I love jumping on the grill and grilling. It's like my favorite thing to do on the weekends, and if I could barbecue every Saturday or Sunday, like I would. So I just love doing that. Ending the night with a good movie, waking up the next day, having breakfast, and then maybe visiting my parents, visiting my family for a couple hours, and then just coming back home and calling me a night. Like that's like favorite weekend. Ooh, that's like favorite weekend for me. Wow, I'm like really surprised that I like these, like this type of sushi over here, because I haven't really like had it, but it is bomb. I love salmon, I love the albacore. I think, I don't know what is what, but I know this is tuna, and then this one, I'm not exactly sure what it is, but it is bomb, super bomb. I think, what else do you guys need to know about me? Eventually, I'm gonna be doing a Q&A. I'm gonna do a Q&A in my channel, on my Instagram. I have some white rice here that I haven't really touched because I didn't really wanna get too full. I'm gonna be doing a Q&A on my Instagram once I reach 1,000 subscribers. Okay, so once I reach 1,000 subscribers, I'm gonna do a Q&A where you guys can ask questions that I don't answer here, or whatever you guys, whatever else you choose most wanna know. So, if you guys are not following me on my Instagram, go follow me. It's at Damian Boss. I post a lot of, I post a lot of my stories, but anytime I post a new video, you guys will see that up there. I just did a giveaway this week. So if you guys are watching this video before June 26th, make sure you guys go look at my Instagram at Damian Boss. I'm giving away a free Pop Babies blender bottle. It's a really cool portable blender that I did a review on, and the company actually reached out and it was like, hey, we want to give one away to your subscribers, to your followers. We'll send you one, you send it to the winner, run the contest. So yeah, I did it. I'm running a whole contest this week. So if you're watching this video today, which is Tuesday, and if you watch it before Friday, June 26th, you guys should go to my Instagram at Damian Boss. There's four easy things that you guys got to do to win the Pop Babies portable blender bottle. And yeah, it's a free blender, which is, it's a really cool blender. You guys got to go check it out. Okay, so let's talk about drinks. What I enjoy drinking. Definitely a tequila person. I love tequila. Like vodka comes second, and I'm not talking about like plain old Grey Goose and Absolut. That's disgusting. That's for like crazy people. I prefer like Ciroc or like flavored vodka. But yeah, tequila all the way though, like squirt and tequila, like a paloma, or just like squirt and tequila with lime juice or orange juice. Bomb. That's like my go-to drink. I like beer too though. Been trying to stay away from the beer. You know, beer gets you fat. Not like tequila doesn't, but beer gets you fatter and I end up bloated and I get a beer belly and I'm not trying to have that. So I already do have that, but I'm not trying to get bigger. So yeah, no beer. I like beer, but try to stay away from it often. My favorite beer I would say is Dos Equis, and then I would go with Pacifico, and then from Pacifico I would do maybe Modelo, and then Corona last. All of my beer though, I need to have a lime in it. Like if you hand me a beer without a lime, I'll drink it, but it's gonna be very hard. I prefer like a cold ass beer with lime. I don't have any kids, if you guys are wondering. No kids yet. Now I do want a kid at some point in my life. I don't know when. I don't think right now is the right time to have a kid yet, especially like we're like going through a pandemic. Not the right time to have a kid, but soon, hopefully in the next, you know, 2 to 3 years. I think right now I'm like really focused on saving for a home and buying a house. I think once I have a house, I would feel much more ready to bring a child into this world. I don't want to have my kid grow up in a small, you know, apartment or home. Like, I just want them to be comfortable in. You know, I feel like right now living in an apartment, we feel like we don't have space, and we have a ton of space, but we just feel like we don't. So imagine when you bring a kid and you have like a car seat and a crib and their clothes and their bottles. Like, where the heck do you put all that stuff when you live in a small apartment? Oh yeah, no kids for me yet, but hopefully in the next 2 to 3 years with God's plan, God's permission, right? My favorite music is reggaeton. If you guys didn't already know that, you guys know now. Like, all the reggaeton artists, like, all-time favorite is J Balvin. I just watched his YouTube, like, Colores album, like, behind the scenes or, like, in the making. It was, like, a little, like, YouTube live premiere thing that he did on Saturday. Yeah, I just love J Balvin. Like, that guy is, like, all good vibes all around. Like, it was cool to see the people that were interviewing with him talk about how good of a guy he is. Because that's like what I want to be seen as in life, you know. Like, I don't want people to like talk smack or talk bad about me, and you know, I want to leave a good impression on people always, and I think J Balvin does that. Bad Bunny is super dope, of course. Like, that guy is just like going super hard. Like, 2 albums in 2020 within like 3 months, like I think March, and then he's dropped the second one like in May or something. Like, who does that? Like, and I think the new album, he did it during the whole pandemic. I know he was quarantined with his girlfriend in Puerto Rico, but yeah, super talented guy. And I just love that reggaeton is just kind of rising right now, and it's becoming way more mainstream. I think it does a good job of just putting our Latino culture like out there, and people are getting to know like more about the Latino culture and respecting it more. Like, it's just really cool. We saw like the Super Bowl, right, have like J Balvin and Bad Bunny. Like, Bad Bunny doesn't even speak English, or he doesn't really speak perfect English. I think he speaks better English now, but yeah, he doesn't speak, he's like literally native to English, and he was performing at the Super Bowl. That's like the US's number one show that people watch in the year. And I think there's, yeah, super cool, because that's like like our fellow Latinos being on like a stage like the Super Bowl. So, I love reggaeton. I prefer reggaeton over hip hop. Like, I'll bump the same music. I love bumping the old throwback reggaeton like Don Omar and Daddy Yankee. I am a big fan of Kanye. Love Ye. A big fan of Drake. You know, I feel like it sucks that Kanye has had some bad moments in his life, but he's not perfect. No one's perfect, and I think he's getting better, and he's following, you know, he's following God, as he says, and I think that's helped him just kind of grow, and he's becoming a better person. So people cut him some slack, you know? Well, I'm almost done. Now, I'm not gonna finish this section because I'm gonna save it for Lucy. There's too much to finish the whole thing, considering that I didn't eat anything all day, but it still gets you pretty full. But I hope that you guys enjoyed this little video. This is my first mukbang, by the way, and it was really cool. It was really fun to make it. I can't believe people do this like as a living. Like, people record themselves eating, which is pretty crazy to me. Oh, I don't understand, but I respect the hustle. And there goes my last bite. Get that soy sauce. Super bomb. All right, y'all. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. I'll see you guys at the next one. Peace.